Could the New York Giants try to trade Sterling Shepard to the New Orleans Saints? I thought this idea was rather fascinating. Floated out there by USA Today. I will make note, the Saints version of the USA Today wire. So it does make some sense, right? The Giants have depth at receiver, and as we'll see in a minute, the Saints very much do not. Now, one big issue here is the nearly $7 million base salary the Giants, for now, have to pay Sterling Shepard. If they were to trade him, in this case, the Saints would take on that base salary. The Giants would save that amount of money on their salary cap. So a trade is doable from New York's perspective. Might be a bit tricky from a salary cap standpoint, though, from New Orleans. But if anybody can manipulate the cap, it is New Orleans. So here was the USA Today trade idea. The Saints, of course, get Sterling Shepard from New York, and the Giants then get a 2022 fifth-round pick. That is what the Saints also have to get Quan Alexander, which didn't work out great in the end. So who says no? Get your votes in, folks. Who says no to this hypothetical trade idea? Type in G for the Giants or type in S for the Saints. Now, the money is an issue for New Orleans, but they need receiver help. Obviously, Michael Thomas is awesome. Traquan Smith is entering year two or so of this is the breakout year. And then wide receiver three is Deontay Harris, Marquez Callaway, Lil Jordan Humphrey. They don't really have a great wide receiver three, even if Traquan Smith does break out. Like, even if Adam Troutman does break out as their leading tight end. They need more help at the wide receiver position. And Shepard would be, if not the third best, maybe even the second best receiver on this team. Like, it's very clear there. We've seen flashes of great play, the stuff that got him paid. 2019, 57 catches, averaged about 10 yards per catch, just three touchdowns there. The volume went up in 2020, but the production and the efficiency did dip a little bit. Shepard is not an elite receiver, but if he's your third or second guy, maybe your low end two, higher end three, that's not bad. He is a good route runner, I think would fit very well in the Saints offense. In New York, meanwhile, it's very clear that his time is limited. Kenny Golladay signed this offseason. He's not going anywhere. He is now their number one guy. They drafted Kadarius Toney in round one. He's going to play some slot. Well, with Darius Slayton also on the outside, despite what the Giants might push publicly, Toney's coming for Shepard's job. Yes, Shepard can also play on the outside. Is he going to play over Darius Slayton? I'm not sure. Because of that, the drafting of Kadarius Toney, I think, made it pretty clear. Sterling Shepard's time is limited in New York. If the Giants can find a trade partner, and if they trust Toney, I'd be all over this, and I'd do that deal right now.